starting fires that you'll never be able to put out. Town by town, I strike a match and then I watch that city burn to the ground. You wanna reach out and say yeah.
Devour of the Day is, I mean, you guys are new to me, but I immediately liked what I heard. Can you tell me about how it started out for you guys? How the band get started?
The band came out of the ashes of my previous band, which was named Egypt Central. Our singer left the band unexpectedly, and we just kind of picked up where he left off, and we started writing new songs for this new project, and everybody was interested in seeing what you know, this could do, because it seemed like it was more, I guess I would say it was from the heart, it was closer to the heart for us, mm-hmm. and our label was hearing that and enjoying the music. And so when we got to the point where we had to, it was either shit or get off the pot, so to say, we just decided that it was time to put this whole thing in at full speed, I'd say, and that's how we got started. It just, you know, kind of a necessity type thing. What is that saying? Invention is the mother of incessity. What's it called?
I follow you.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying.
I got you. Now, yeah, man, your debut album, Time and Pressure, just dropped just over a month ago. How's it all going?
It's going excellent so far. I mean, we've had great responses everywhere. We've played 8 shows so far, and all of them have been incredible. And we're just, as a band, we are in a really good place mentally for this whole project.
Cool. Now, the band, I mean, initially everything I'm looking at, the band is just listed as you and Joey. Now, are you guys a full-fledged band yet, or who does the shows with you live? What's going on there?
We have 2 touring musicians. We have Dustin Schoenhofer, he's our drummer, and we have Jeff James, that used to be in our previous band. He's playing guitar with us.
Cool.
And we have our same label, a lot of the same team behind us. So it's as close to the original or the previous band as you could get without
without the bullshit.
Without our, yeah, right.
Gotcha. Now, I see you guys are doing shows with Seven Dust and Hinder, both very cool bands. I've talked to both of them recently. How did that come together, and are you looking forward to it?
When we got to the point where we wanted to start touring with this band, I called Cody, the drummer from Hinder, and
good dude.
Let him know, let him hear the music. I told him that we were, you know, wanting to get on the map and that we'd really like to do some shows, if possible, because we share the same booking agency. And I think he put in a word over at his to get that ball rolling, and when it did, we were just, you know, ecstatic to know that we were going out with old friends rather than, you know, a brand new touring circuit, because usually you tour with somebody for a month, 2 months, and by the right when the tour is over is like right when you start to be, you know, close with everybody. And so it was great for us to have our first tour be with some old friends and such a good band and such good dudes. And this Seven Dust tour, though, that's that kind of came up out of nowhere, and we share the same booking agency, so when
that always helps.
Sorry, go ahead.
That always helps.
Yeah, we were ecstatic. We just, like, I mean, it's a bucket list type thing for me personally, and I've always been a huge fan of Seven Dust.
Yeah, me too, man. Now, you talk about the pressures when writing this album on the band's bio. Can you talk about that a little bit?
I'm sorry, say that again?
You talk about pressures when you're writing this on your band's bio. Can you talk about that a little bit?
The pressure?
Yeah, you said you had pressures when writing this album.
Well, the pressures of being able to follow up with something better or just as good as our previous group, that was a huge pressure. personally going from drums to singing, I was scared shitless that people would just be like, oh, that guy sucks. You know, I can't sing. I hate his voice. And, you know, if they are saying that, then they're keeping it a secret, which is great.
No, you can sing, brother. So, you can sing just fine.
Thanks.
All right.
So we, there's just pressure from every angle. And I think when we finally got out on the road and started playing shows and got some reaction and listening to what our friends and family that have been with us since the beginning, to hear what they had to say, a lot of that weight was lifted. But, you know, there's still a considerable amount of pressure to, you know, go above and beyond everything that we've done before and to truly succeed in this world. So it's not over yet, but we're still working on it.
I mean, everything I heard on the album, from what I've heard, you're going to be fine. But it's, you know, tight, it's energetic, aggressive yet melodic, and it goes in several directions. Can you talk about the band's sound a little bit? What were you guys going for, or did it just come out naturally?
It really just came out naturally. I mean, we started doing these songs in the very beginning just as therapy, you know, and
right.
as a way to kind of talk about what had happened to us and to get some stuff off of our chests. And so when the music was coming together for it, we tried a couple different things, but when we sat down and listened to the entire project as a whole, we decided that it was best to stay with our roots and to stay in the more aggressive side of music. And it translates live, which is great, because sometimes, you know, what you do in the studio doesn't come across. And as far as like what we sound like, I don't know, because I'm too close to the project to tell you that. But
right.
I will say that that personally, I like this music. It's close to heart, and it's exactly what I wanted the group to sound like.
Yeah, it's new and fresh, man. It's really good stuff. So, and I just found out about you. Actually, somebody else locally turned me on and said, hey, have you heard of these guys? And I said, no. So she gave me the link, and I'm like, whoa, hey now, who's this? So, Respect is a very cool tune. Can you talk about that song a little bit?
The song, we've never gone that deep into the harder side of rock, and so we were pushing our limits there, and it was a given that was a I don't know, I guess what I'm trying to say is that's as aggressive as we've ever been, and it feels really, really, really good.
Fair enough.
That song live, and it's kind of a shock and awe thing, I think, with these audiences, because so far, you know, we've been the more aggressive band on the bill. However, you know, that's going to change the first day of the 7th tour.
Right.
But I feel like it's closer to home with me as far as like my personal tastes. And so when we finish that song and what it's about being so close to our true thoughts of what happened to our last group, and with it being so aggressive, it just, to us, it's like, it's the song that really, really sums up what happened to us the best.
Oh, okay. Well said. Okay, now I'm going to go on the lighter side. You have some very interesting video clips on your website, especially you and your dog. Those are hilarious.
I think it was just from being at home for more than a week and getting bored and just realizing that I don't belong here.
So you get stir crazy and chew on your dog's ear. Good.
Right, exactly.
All right. What's the plan as summer rolls in, and what's in the future for you guys? Do you plan in to keep this rolling? Or?
Yeah, we're going to tour for the rest of the year, probably next year off the same record, and we're looking to go back into the studio at some point later next year and pump out another record. And we really the plan. It's just a tour, 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 tour until we ride the wheels off of the of our vehicle. So.
Gotcha. Well, don't chew your dog's ear off when you get home, all right? All right, last one. It's the usual last one. Is there anything that you want to say to the readers and the fans?
I just want to say thank you for all the support and, you know, for taking the time to find out what goes on behind the scenes over here and to be accepted after, you know, what I feel like is a slap in the face just to quit such a great opportunity that we had, and to start something new and to be accepted with open arms is something that we can't pay back. And so I just want to say thank you to everybody that that gave us a second chance.
Run like a bitch!